What's up, YouTube? Scott, Scotty Tradition, back with another video. Hope you guys are doing well. Nationals only 2 weeks away, less than 2 weeks at this point, so getting pretty excited about that. But the reason I'm making this video is I just wanted to say thank you for everybody that has subscribed to my channel over the years. It was just come to my attention about a month ago, actually, that I hit the 1,000 subscriber mark. It's a little over that now, but kind of a big deal in the niche sports card collecting community to hit 1,000 subscribers. I look back at my first video that I made, and that was about 8 years ago, 2015. It was actually a PSA submission video, and it was kind of funny. I look back to some of the cards that I had submitted, and I have very few of those cards anymore. It was a mix of like Jabari Parker rookies and Davante Adams and HaHa Clinton Dix and all kinds of players like that. So, you know, I think I have less than 10% of those cards that I had, but I remember being so excited in the video that, you know, just getting graded cards back for the first time. And you know, it's just funny over the years, you realize, like, you know, maybe which cards you should grade, which cards you necessarily shouldn't have. But it was a fun first video nonetheless. That was about 8 years ago. And then I really started getting heavy into making videos about 6 years ago. And you know, I've done that consistently ever since. So I think I have about 383 videos right now, I think was the number overall. So that's, you know, that's a pretty steady array of videos over the last 6 years, ever since 2017 for sure. And then obviously that first video I had was from 2015. So it takes a lot to get to 1,000 subscribers, especially when you're not trying to do what the masses want you to do. If you have a channel that's just collecting based, and you're kind of going through your niche, and my niche is Wisconsin sports, vintage football, and some vintage baseball mixed in, but those are kind of the primary things that I have on my channel, as you all know from over the years. So it just takes a while to get to that number. So I just want to say thank you to everyone who has contributed to that over the last number of years. I possibly am going to do some type of contest to commemorate that. We'll probably wait to do that till after the National sometime, though. I don't want to put up a contest now with so many distractions going on. And also, another thing that I've had going on is my stepdad's actually just entered hospice care this week, so... they've got a nurse coming out to the house and stuff to help manage his pain better. For those of you that know me best, know that my stepdad has been going through prostate cancer the last 4 years. He was actually given only about 6 months because it was such an aggressive form. This was back 4 years ago, and he's obviously still going. So he's into the like top 5% of people that make it this long for the type of cancer that he has. So he's a tough guy, he's a battler, and he's battled hard this whole time. But at this point, it's just kind of spread to the point where he's in a ton of pain, and he's kind of entered hospice care to get better pain management and whatnot. So I went over there this weekend and got to spend some time with him, with my boys, and did some yard work for him, and I brought over some meals. So, you know, that was great to have that time. So I'm hoping that I can still make it to the National, is kind of where I'm going with this. I know he would certainly want me to go and to enjoy myself. So, you know, unless the unforeseen happens, I do plan on going to the National and being there all 5 days. But I will kind of have one kind of ear on the other stuff as well. But yeah, it's been a long road. Part of that, you know, the reasons I haven't been making tons of videos lately and tons of pickups, you know, I've had that in the back of my mind too. The last couple of years, so and that's been, you know, kind of taxing on the family. It's hard when you have a somebody that you love and care about that isn't doing well. It just takes a lot out of you. So basically, really looking forward to the National. Obviously, I didn't go last year in AC. This one's way closer, way easier to get to, and just a lot better feel from what I'm told. And the last two times I went, 2019 and 2021, was awesome. So really hoping to make it this year as well. Pretty much all I got. I haven't really had any pickups. I did go to a card shop the other day with my boys and pick them up some Pokemon, which they had fun with. And I opened up a box of, let's see, what was it? 2023 Heritage Baseball. So opened up a box of that. Ended up getting a relic card as my card. And I opened up a box of Bowman Yu Inception, which I did not do well on. And it kind of reminds me why I don't open boxes of cards. So they just got a couple autos in there, nothing too big. And then I did get some rookies in that Heritage box for fun. But yeah, overall, I would say I didn't do that great on the boxes. God willing, if I can make it out to the National, which is still my plan, hope to pick up at least a big card or two there. Have not picked up a lot of stuff this year. I picked up a few things to start the year, but not a whole lot since. It's been pretty quiet as far as pickups go. So, kind of getting that itch to add something to the collection. Other than that, I'm really looking forward to seeing everybody. Hope you guys are doing well, and we'll talk to you again soon. Thanks everybody for watching.